This video uses reaction wheels developed by University of Bristol and the CubeSat ESAT developed by FIA Space. Reaction wheels are a kind of flywheel used for the attitude control and stability of a spacecraft. By adding or removing energy from the flywheel, torque is applied to a single axis of a spacecraft, causing it to react by rotating. The attitude is controlled by the change in speed. By maintaining flywheel rotation, called momentum, a single axis of a spacecraft is stabilized. Their operation is based on a Newton's third law that you may all know, that for every action, there is equal and opposite reaction. So, if the reaction wheel is accelerated counterclockwise, it creates an internal torque on the spacecraft clockwise. This is the University of Bristol air bearing test bed with a simple reaction wheel. It has been instructed to move the system by 180 degrees. It can be seen that the system passes 180 degrees and the reaction wheel compensates that by spinning in a different direction. Reaction wheels can provide high pointing accuracy and are very useful in the cases when a spacecraft needs to be rotated by very small amounts. For example, they can keep the telescope pointing at a distant exoplanet. However, reaction wheels can rotate a spacecraft only around its center of mass. They are not capable of moving the spacecraft from one place to another. Usually, three or more reaction wheels are used on a spacecraft to provide full three-axis attitude control and stability. However, the ESAT has only one reaction wheel for demonstration. Of course, there are some advantages and disadvantages of the reaction wheels. The pros of the reaction wheels are that they do not consume fuel and are relatively power efficient. Unlike the magnetorquers, they do not rely on the magnetic field and are suitable for the deep space missions. They also store angular momentum. The main disadvantage is that the reaction wheel is a mechanism, and no one really wants a mechanism in space. A mechanism needs lubrication, generates microvibration, and if it fails, the mission can fail too. Another disadvantage of a reaction wheel is that over time, reaction wheels may build up enough stored momentum to exceed maximum speed of a wheel, called saturation, which will need to be cancelled. That's why the reaction wheel system are supplemented with attitude control mechanisms such as magnetorquers. To summarize, reaction wheels are used for the attitude control and stability of a spacecraft. By spinning the wheel, torque is applied to a single axis of a spacecraft. The pros are, they provide high pointing accuracy, they are power efficient, and they do not rely on a magnetic field. The cons are that it is a mechanism, they can only rotate the spacecraft, and they generate saturation.